Well, one of the most exciting varieties or sets of varieties that are coming out today are flood-tolerant varieties. Now, rice is a great crop for a monsoon environment like you have in all over Asia, in that it can tolerate and quite happily grow in waterlogged soils or even standing water up to 10, 15, 20 centimeters, say 10 inches deep. But when it goes completely underwater in a flood, it dies like any other crop, it drowns. We have developed, or our scientists have developed, rice varieties that carry a single gene that allows them to survive a total flood of 3 weeks or maybe more. Now, what that means is that these areas of Asia and parts of Africa and Latin America that are regularly flooded will not have their rice crop destroyed. And that's something that is extremely important for the farmers in these areas. And our scientists, when they go to the village and where these varieties are being evaluated, are met like almost like gods or heroes, because these people who routinely go through periods of severe famine after a flood are now seeing their crops coming back. So that's something that is moving out into the field. We expect by this year to have those varieties that were just actually taken and evaluated in farmers' field for the first time in 2007 into the hands of over a million farmers in India and Bangladesh alone. So that's a phenomenal shift. And they're great varieties, but what's even more important is that the farmers are seeing that there is reason to believe that new seed can bring new and better varieties. We have also under development a golden rice, which carries beta carotene, which is a precursor to vitamin A. Vitamin A is one of the most serious nutritional problems. Vitamin A deficiency is one of the most serious nutritional problems in the world today. Areas that are heavily dependent on rice are also areas where you have a lot of vitamin A deficiency. So we expect to have those varieties out in around 2013-2014, starting in the Philippines. Now that's going to be interesting because it's a transgenic product. So there's going to be, I think it's going to be a face-off that's going to occur between those who oppose on ideological grounds transgenic varieties faced with the prospect that their opposition could in fact deny an extraordinarily nutritious food to some of the poorest people in the world. So stay tuned for that one. Other varieties or materials that are coming out are, we have identified some good drought tolerance in rice, and we're combining that drought tolerance with flood tolerance. So we're going to have available to farmers rice varieties that are both tolerant of floods and tolerant to drought. Now that's a seeming contradiction, but in many parts of the world, a farmer who's depending on rainfall for their water for their rice crop may have a flood in early in the year or mid-season, and then they'll have a late-season drought. Okay, I mean it's just sort of adding insult to injury, but this is the sort of thing that people have to face. And what's interesting about these, drought tolerance and flood tolerance, if you think about the impact of climate change and you look at any reasonable prediction of what's going to be occurring, there's going to be, in many parts of the world, increasing frequencies of floods and droughts. So our work that's targeting the poorest of the poor today, who suffer drought, who suffer some floods on a regular basis, is at the same time anticipating challenges are coming our way from climate change. So I call that a convenient convergence. And I was calling that before Al Gore came out with his inconvenient truth. And I have to say that I had to stop talking about my convenient convergence because people thought I took the idea from Al Gore, but I actually beat him to it. So.